Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. So it is the first favorites video of the entire year, and I'm really excited to say that. Just before I filmed this, I thought, do I still want to make favorites videos? Is it like a really redundant thing? But I don't think it's redundant, because it's a time of the month where I just get to sit and chat with you guys. I give you a little update like on what's happening on my life, and also tell you what I've been loving that month. So I really like doing favorites videos, and I'm going to keep doing it. So let's first start with the life update bit. January was a pretty busy month, and I was preparing for stuff and all, because I pre-filmed this video a few days earlier. If all goes well, I am going to be on my vacation when you guys are watching this. So yeah, there's just generally going to be a lot of Instagram updates, because that's just the app that I like using the most. And January was also really special for me, because we adopted our third cat. She's a sweet little girl kitten, our first girl kitten, because we had two male cats before that. We were only supposed to be fostering her, but yet again we fell in love with her and we adopted her. She's just adorable, and her name is Brittany, but we call her Tiny most of the time. So now on to the favorites of the month. I'm going to start with makeup as usual, but I also have some lifestyle favorites, some consumables, and a fashion favorite as well. So let's talk mascara. I found and started using two mascaras that I really, really like this month. Actually, this one I started using earlier, but still, it's the Barbie Big Eyes Mascara. It's not available in India, unfortunately. It is available only in a few other Asian countries, like I think Hong Kong, Singapore, and stuff. I picked it up from Thailand, and this is a really interesting mascara. I featured it in a Get Ready With Me video as well, where I demonstrated it, and I also featured it in my first Bangkok haul. It has just a regular black mascara on one side and fibers on the other side, and it works really well at building up the thickness of your lash. And I really like it, because it's been giving me super, super thick lashes, and that's what I crave the most, volume. And the second thing that I've enjoyed using is the new Lakme Iconic Curling Mascara in blue. I was so excited that Lakme launched their own blue mascara shade. I also did a blog post review on it, so you can check out my blog post to see like detailed review and pictures. So I'm not going to waste too much of time talking about this mascara. I really like the color it gives. And do check out my blog post for a super detailed review, but I recommend it. I'm wearing both of these on my lashes today. I put on like a thick layer of this black mascara, and I topped it with the blue. So there's a lot of product on my lashes right now, but I really like how they look, because it's always nice to have voluminous lashes without resorting to falsies. So the next makeup favorite is something that, again, I've had for a couple of months, but I've only just recently begun using. It's the Lakme Absolute Moonlit Highlighter. So this highlighter has two sides to it. On one side, there's a sort of a slightly pinky, slightly champagne-y, light shimmery highlighter, and on the other side there is a bronzy highlighter. Both of them are very, very beautiful. You can swirl like the brush in both the colors and just use both of them, or you can like pick up a specific color, because they're quite thick, so you can actually put the brush on only one side without any issues. So I usually use both of them. I'll use the bronzy one a little bit like lower on my cheeks, something like a contour, but a shimmery contour, and I'll use this one on the higher points of my cheeks. I think it's a wonderful, wonderful highlighter, because there aren't that many Indian brands that make good powder highlighters. This one is really nice, and it's not like the cheapest thing in the world, but I would still call it a decent budget highlighter. And it isn't so shimmery as, say, the Mary Luminizer or something, so it's not easy to go overboard on it. If you guys have been looking to purchase your very first highlighter, I would thoroughly recommend this. Or even if you just want another highlighter, it's really pretty, and I've been wearing it almost every single time. And I don't wear blush or anything on my cheeks. I just go in with this highlighter, and I go for a pretty subtle one, but you can go bold as well. So I have one fashion favorite this time, and it is this bag from Accessorize. I'm not usually that much of a bag person. I don't buy a lot of bags or anything like that. I just like having a few, and I keep on using them until they become really old and don't look so good, and then I have to get rid of them. So this is one bag that I think, yeah, I got in January, only at the beginning of Jan, and I really, really like it, because it's a leather bag, and the shape of the bag is, I would say, quite conventional. It's a structured bag, but nothing too wild. It's got a lot of space, it's got pockets to segregate your stuff, But what makes it really unique is this strap. You might have already seen this bag on my Instagram. It's got these like leather floral appliques throughout the strap. And I think that's what makes it so, so unique. I've seen similar bags like this with floral appliques from Coach. And that is pretty much a high-end brand and they cost like 40,000-50,000 or something. And it's so much more affordable compared to that. And the great thing about this is you also get a regular strap, which I left at home, I don't have right now, which is just like a regular leather blue strap. So if you want to like take this bag to work and you think the flowers would be too wild, you can go for just that regular strap. But I don't think that's going to get a lot of use from me because I like the flower one, but it's good to have options. You guys know that I really, really like tea, and I've made so many tea haul videos on my channel. Every time I make a tea haul video, you ask for more. So this is not something new per se. If you watch my tea haul videos, you would have seen this. It is the Tea Box Bombay Cutting Chai. I also have the box somewhere here. It's vacuum packed, so it's totally fresh. Now, Tea Box teas are not exactly the cheapest teas in the world, but this Bombay Cutting Chai is the best chai tea that I've tasted in my entire life. It's just so, so, so amazing. It's got a lot of fennel flavor in it. I think fennel is called sonf, yes. I always get confused, but anyway, you might think like, what is sonf doing in a tea? But it just adds so much of freshness. It's a very unique tea and it's very nice. If you like chai and masala chai type of teas, I think this would become your favorite masala chai. If you don't even like chais, I think this might be the chai to convert you and bring you onto tea side. It's really, really amazing. And I mean, I'm not overhyping it. You guys have got to taste it for yourself because it's just super. It's available on the Tea Box website. And I actually have like a discount for you guys. If you sign up through the link below, you can get 50% off on your first order. And I think it was available on Amazon as well. So if you want to buy like just one tea, you can even try it out on Amazon. And if you decide to try it out, let me know what you think. Already a few of you guys after watching my last tea haul told me you tried it and you liked it. But I'd love to know your honest opinions if you decide to buy it. So my final item that kind of goes with the tea is the mug that I'm drinking the tea out of. And I'm being really careful because it's full of tea right now. Just gonna take a sip. I'm sure most of you guys would have heard of Kat Kidston, or even if you haven't heard of her name, I'm sure you've seen her designs. She's really famous for making a lot of lifestyle products and they incorporate very iconic elements of London. And she's also famous for making these. So this is from the limited edition Kat Kidston and Disney collaboration. I'm a huge fan of having Disney merchandise. Even when I was a kid, my mom bought me like tons of Disney cutlery and crockery and stuff. So they had a Mickey and Minnie version. I got the Mickey one. But I'm thinking of going back to get the Minnie one. I like how vibrant this is and it just has like the top half of Mickey, and it's just a super colorful and bright and nice mug that I've enjoyed sipping my morning and evening tea out of. So those were all my favorites for the month of January. If you have actually found something that you really enjoyed in the month of January, please share a comment below and let me know. And if you have any questions as well, just feel free to leave a comment. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.